This week at LSU Eunice, we take a look at next week's accreditation team's visit, community service, a magician visits campus, and the student government's LSU tailgate party. Next week is one of the most important weeks at LSU Eunice. The Southern Association of Colleges and Schools Commission on the College's Reaffirmation Team will be on campus. SACSCOC is the regional body for the accreditation of degree-granting higher education institution.
I'm excited to have a few minutes to update you on where we are in our process of reaffirmation of accreditation. As you have probably heard, we're in the midst of reaffirming our accreditation with the Southern Association of Colleges and Schools Commission on Colleges, which is the accrediting bodies for the states in the southern region. So far, we have submitted a compliance certification that was back in March. And to give you an idea of what was involved in that process, we are held to 90 plus standards in the Principles of Accreditation Foundations for Quality Enhancement. And you can think of it more or less as a take-home test. We have to respond to these 90 principles. We have to tell them what we're doing and how we're doing it. We submitted that report in March, and that report went to our what is considered our off-site committee. Now, the people reviewing these documents are all representatives from peer institutions, institutions like ourselves. So they reviewed our document and they came back and said we did a very good job. They had a few questions and we answered those questions in what is considered a focused report. The next phase of the process will kick off next week. Next week, you're going to see 9 or 10 individuals walking around campus. They're going to be asking questions. They're going to be having meetings with various personnel on campus, and they are considered our on-site review committee. And what they're here to do is to take a little closer look. Are we doing what we said we were doing in the compliance certification document? So don't be surprised and don't be alarmed if they stop you on the sidewalk, introduce themselves, they'll all have name tags, and ask you, what do you think about LSU Eunice? They may also ask you what you think about our quality enhancement plan. I know you've seen the banners on the flagpoles on campus and have received information from your instructors. The quality enhancement plan is also part of this final phase of accreditation. When, as an accredited institution, we are committed to ongoing progress, to enhancing student learning. And in doing so, we need to examine issues that are facing our campus and our students and look at ways to improve on what's happening in the student learning environment. When we did this past year, we found that developmental mathematics was an issue for many students on campus. So in studying the issue, we developed what's called a quality enhancement plan. And this is a course redesign of developmental mathematics. It is taking developmental mathematics, Math 0001 and Math 0002, and offering it in a computerized competency-based format, modular format. So they may ask you, have you heard of it? Are you in the class? Do you know what's going on with the quality enhancement plan? Just, you know, give them honest answers and everything will be fine. I just didn't want you to be alarmed when these total strangers may stop you on the street and ask you what's going on. Once they are finished, which they should wrap up their visit on Thursday, then we'll wait for our final report.
The team could stop any student and ask questions specifically about the LSU Eunice's Quality Enhancement Team, Modular Mathematics. Magician Michael Kent was on campus for the Campus Activities Board Halloween Bash.
Spin. is no Wi-Fi, no, to compare with your imagination. Living there, you'll be free if you truly wish to be.
Local author Todd Elliott spoke at the Ladue Library about his book, A Rose by Many Other Names, about a woman dumped in Eunice who predicted the assassination of President John F. Kennedy 48 hours before he was shot.
But sometimes in America, the truth comes too soon. And that's the case of Rose Sherman, 48 hours before President Kennedy was murdered in Dallas, right here in Eunice, Louisiana. She spoke the truth. No one believed her because it was unbelievable. It was unspeakable, yet she spoke it. It was unthinkable, and she spoke it. And then when it happened, people got scared.
The Student Government Association and Chancellor Nunez will host a tailgate party this weekend at the LSU-Texas A&M game. SGA President Peyton Miller has the details.
Hi everybody, the SGA is hosting a tailgate party with Chancellor Nunez next week at the LSU-Texas A&M game. We will start at 9:30 at Lot 202 by the Indian Mounds. Food and refreshments will be served. Y'all come out and tailgate with us and support the Tigers.
Early registration is currently underway. Don't forget to see your advisor to get cleared to register. This week's Acts 5 is Basil's Victoria Fondo.
It doesn't matter if you want something bad enough, you'll never give up. Because to this day, I still have never gave up, and it got me to a scholarship and my sophomore year in basketball. To be an astronaut and go walk on the moon, always wanted to do that. But unfortunately, I'm too scared, so going for respiratory therapy. The craziest song on my phone is The Wannabe by the Spice Girls.
How's it go?
Alright, no, I can't do it. If I could meet anyone, I would want to meet Michael Jordan because he's famous and he is a great inspiration. And he also stars in one of my favorite movies, Space Jam. My favorite place is the cafeteria, of course. The lunch ladies be jamming sometime.
That's it for this week at LSU Eunice. Gabrielle will be back next week with another look at what's going on around campus.